What's up, all you there in Doomed to You Land? I am TV's Kevin Lanigan.
And I'm Vern. How's it going, y'all?
We wanted to give you all a little update on the season two of Doomed to You that we teased at the very, very end of episode five. So it's been a year since the first season came out, and we just wanted to say definitively, season two will happen.
Yes. It's a thing. I know, like, the show, like, the whole, like, kind of guise of the show is that it, like, messes with the audience and teases things all the time, and I know, like, it was a tease at the end of the last episode, but also not a tease because it really will happen. And before we get into that, I also just want to say, like, because it's been a year, like, thank you guys for watching. Like, and thank you for, like, keeping asking about this show and everything. Like, recently, we were Starable's featured pick for the day. And, like, it's very nice that this show, which was very much a labor of love and very, very stressful to myself and Kevin and Forrest and everyone else involved, that, like, people still, like, care about it and ask about it and are curious about its fate and everything. That means a lot to us. So thank you guys so much for, like, sticking with it.
Absolutely.
Despite, you know, through the time where, like, we didn't have a show anymore because YouTube took us down and all that stuff. Like,
God.
Thank you guys so much.
I had almost forgotten about that shit. Yeah, so this show has been to hell and back several times, and it was in hell for a little bit, and it will come back. We want to say that definitively. Kind of this video is to say that we know it's coming back. We don't know when, and we don't know the specifics, because Vern and I are both unbelievably busy people. We work full-time jobs on top of the creative stuff that we do. As of this recording, Vern is preparing to shoot his first feature film in a couple months.
Okay, if you're listening to this right now, if everything's going okay, if everything's going planned, we're shooting Pet Turtles right now. Like,
as of your watching this, as it uploads,
if as it's as a day it went live, if everything went well, like, 2 months ago, we are going to wrap production on Doomed to You in, or not Doomed to You, season two, excuse me, on Pet Turtles in 2 days.
Right.
If you're listening to this right now, the day it went live and everything went went well, like, earlier.
Yeah. So there's so that is an unbelievably large undertaking. Again, on top of Vern doing, like, freelance jobs and a full-time job and being married and editing some of Puffin every so often. I'm here in New York with my own, like, I work 50, 60 hours a week between, like, multiple jobs, on top of producing YouTube videos on my personal channel, on top of producing The Stone Zone, still being the main editor on Puffin, and the XYZ myriad of other jobs. I don't know how much my life is going to change in the 2 months before this uploads, but trust me when I say I also don't have a lot of free time to put a show together. A personal thank you to everyone who has seen the show and then gone over to my Patreon page and helps me, like, make a little bit of a living off of all this creative stuff. You're helping Doomed to You season two get here even faster, because that allows me to allocate a little bit more time towards making it happen. Another problem standing in the way of season two getting here sooner is the geography involved, because Vern, Forrest, and I believe Avery are in the St. Louis area. Lauren Hayes has moved to Los Angeles, California, and Sam and I live together in New York City. So between our principal cast and our crew, we occupy almost every time zone. If we could get someone in intermountainary time, that would be great.
And it's a thing where, like, once again, if everything's going in motion, by the time you're listening to this, like, at the end of the month, at the end of this month, December, I'll be living in Washington State.
Oh, shit.
And so, like, Kevin and I will literally be on opposite sides of the United States.
Right.
The distance is a thing, but it's a thing that, like, when Doomed to You does get made, when it does start to happen, like, we want to do it right. And that's part of, like, that's part of what took Pet Turtles so long, is, like, I wanted to do it right. And also, like, I didn't realize when editing Doomed to You, and I thought, this is as long as a movie. I can just do a movie that, like, also what made Doom 2 like happen as quick as it did was there's two people working on it.
Yeah.
And you could split. And so like with, if we were to be working on Doom 2 season 2 at the same time as everything else, like our focus would be divvied way too much and something would suffer, and we don't want that to happen. When we do make Doom 2 season 2, and we will, we want to do it right. And we want it to be worth the wait.
Absolutely. If we're going to take 2-3 years to make this happen, like, we want it to be worth the wait, not just for us, but for you, the listening audience as well. And we have a good concept for what the season is, the themes we're going to play with. We have a lot of like jokes and scenes planned out and some of the character arcs. We haven't sat down and written any of the scripts yet, because again, Vern is putting together a feature film and I'm doing all my crap over here. So there is a lot of moving pieces that still need to be laid down. And if we're going to get everybody, if we're going to get the whole gang together for like probably a couple weeks in some location or another, we're probably like, it's a big undertaking. We're going to want to make sure that we do it right, that we have everything planned out. That's the only reason the first season could happen, is because we like had the blueprint at the beginning and could just follow that for the 3-4 months it took us to shoot the damn thing.
And another thing that like made Doom 2 easier, season 1 easier than anything else, is like, with the exception of 3 scenes, all of Doom 2 took place in one building, and like we had the rights to that building.
It was designed around that very easy premise. Was like, we need to shoot this thing in one place.
And finding like Doom 2 season 2, like we've talked about it, and it will most likely all be taking place in another one place. But because it's season 2 and things are bigger, this one place is also going to be bigger. And there's a lot more, like, it's a location that we don't have yet. So, like, there's all sorts of, like, things, and, like, we got to find the right location for it. We have to write it for that location. You know, things like that. Or we have to write and then find the location that fits what we wrote and all this. It's a way bigger undertaking. We want to do it bigger, not just because we can, but because, like, the end of the show had the world ending.
Yeah. So, like, had the world ending, had Nick Fury come in. There's a lot of stuff that happened at the end of the season, and we got to account for all of that when we come back and do another season.
Every episode of Doom 2 built into the next one and got bigger and bigger and bigger. And so, like, the new season needs to show that things have kept getting bigger since we've last left these characters.
Yeah, we're not going to just, like, go back and do a Duplass Brothers movie. Like, it does need to get, or we won't be doing, like, cranes or a lot of big stunts or anything like that, but we do have to account for this world that we've built. There's just a lot of moving pieces, and thank you all for your patience. Thank you again to people that keep watching, that keep supporting the show when we share it, when we do all these different promotional things. Even now, people still respond to the show really, really positively, and we appreciate that, and you're a huge reason why we're putting this much effort into doing a season 2, a much more complicated season 2. So again, from the bottom of our hearts, season 2 will happen, and you will not be disappointed, but it's just going to take a little bit of time.
It's going to take a second. Kevin and myself and Forrest all had to go work on our solo albums before we got the band back together, but we will get the band back together, and it will happen, and it's something that, like, every single time we've ever talked about Doom 2 Season 2, which has been a lot, we've gotten more and more excited about it. So it's a thing we're putting a lot of effort into, a lot of planning into, and because we want to do it right. And unfortunately, like, right takes time, but when it does happen, we think that you're going to be pretty pleased with it and pretty happy with it. So yeah, as Kevin said, and as I said earlier, like, thank you guys so much for supporting the show, and we hope that you also enjoyed all the other stuff that we put up today.
Yeah,
the BTS and the bloopers and all that sort of good stuff. It was fun getting back in there, and like, it was rough living in the Doom 2 world for a long time there, but it was nice to go back there and visit.
Now we can view it with rose-colored glasses and not have to worry about making the damn thing. We can look at all the fun parts and enjoy and bask in those. And yes, so everyone's on board. Everyone has said yes. It's just gonna be a minute because we don't have Marvel money. We don't have Pirates of the Caribbean money to get this to happen. Give us some time, and it'll be there,
please.
And we'll close this out as we close it all out. Oh, baby, life can be like the movies. Remember, that's from the show.
Oh yeah. It's pretty good. I was gonna say it's pretty fun, but it's not actually. That's one of the sadder parts of the show. What, but, you know, it's a thing.
Where am I gonna get a fucking gavel?
There we go, yeah, and then I'll put the... Look, there's a banana stuff. Look,
this has funny. Been Stuff That Happened. I'm Daniel St. Dubois.
And I'm Dr. Brown. Bye.
Bye.